and Marion. Should you call her a rancher, a businesswoman, or an art lover? It's best just to call her all three. The 2001 Golden Spur Award winner, Ann Winfor Marion, was born to one of the largest ranches in the United States. The land was fertile with oil and stocked with cattle. As the sole heir, she would have it all. But it's the way Ann used her birthright that brings us here tonight. Ann Winfor Marion was born November 10, 1938 in Fort Worth, the only child of Ann Burnett Hall. Known as Miss Ann raised her daughter to appreciate the arts, to be a tough businesswoman, and to love the ranch that she would one day own. Nicknamed Little Ann by the ranch cowboys who called her mother Miss Ann, Ann lived with her mother in Fort Worth and was educated at the finest schools back east. But she spent the summers on the famed Four Sixes Ranch, established in 1870 by her great-grandfather, Samuel Burke Burnett. "I rode from daylight till dark with the cowboys at the ranch," she remembers. "I did what they did." A self-proclaimed tomboy, Ann was a pest to those ranch cowboys. She tells of putting nails under saddle blankets, then receiving a deserved spanking from the hired hands. She also remembers having her mouth washed out with soap after mimicking the foul language used by the men. She quickly found the tough cowboys didn't appreciate such talk from a young lady. After time spent at the University of Texas in Austin and the University of Geneva in Geneva, Switzerland, Ann settled back in Fort Worth to begin her business career. When her mother passed away in 1980, Ann took her place as head of Burnett Ranches, which included the famed Four Sixes. Samuel Burke Burnett was born in Bates County, Missouri on January 1, 1849. His father, Jerry, farmed and ran a general store for a time until the family was raided by jayhawking marauders. The elder Burnett loaded the wagon and moved his family through fierce Indian country, settling in Denton County, Texas, when Burke was 10 years old. There, on the open range, the elder Burnett entered the cattle business. Burke Burnett trailed his first herd of cattle north to Kansas when he was only 17 years old. At 18, he drove his father's herd to Abilene, Kansas, surviving stampedes and Indian raids. When he was 19, Burke bought cattle that carried the famous Four Sixes brand. Legend has it that Burke won the herd with a poker hand of Four Sixes. The less romantic story holds true, though. The origin of the Four Sixes brand is still unknown. Burke began buying land in north central Texas, some for as cheap as 25 cents an acre, and established his ranch headquarters near the present-day Wichita Falls. Through buying and leasing land, Burke soon grazed cattle on 300,000 acres. During this time, Burke developed a friendship with the last Comanche chief, Quanah Parker. The Comanche so respected the rancher that they gave him a name in their own language, Masasuta, meaning Big Boss. In 1874, Burke bought a herd of steers for fattening, the first rancher known to make such a purchase. In 1877, he was one of 40 cattlemen to form the Texas and Southwestern Cattle Raisers Association. Soon after the turn of the century, Burke bought the 8 Ranch in Guthrie, forming the nucleus of what is today the Four Sixes Ranch. He also bought the Dixon Creek Ranch. Little did he know, the first oil strike on Burnett property would be on the Dixon Creek Ranch in 1921. In the early years at Guthrie, Burke established the 4-6 Supply House, where he kept an office and lived while at the ranch. Today, that same supply house is a general store open to the public as well as the ranch. In 1917, Burke decided to build the finest ranch house in West Texas. The house cost $100,000 and was built from stone quarried on the ranch. That home still stands as a testament to the traditions of the ranch. When Burke died in 1922, only one of his three children still lived. His son Tom had been educated in the East, but the ranch was Tom's true calling. He learned the business literally from the ground up. Tom was well-liked and respected by cowmen and ranch hands alike. He was a keen judge of both horses and cattle. Tom developed the Triangle Ranches near Iowa Park and Paducah, Texas. Tom died in 1938, leaving the massive ranch to his only heir, a daughter named Ann. Miss Ann also had impeccable judgment for horses and cattle, and she was a fine businesswoman. It was at Miss Ann's house in 1940 when a group of horsemen first kicked around the idea of an association for those bulldog-type cow horses they were riding. The next day, that group of folks formed the American Quarter Horse Association. and was the association's first female honorary vice president, and was later inducted into the American Quarter Horse Hall of Fame. Upon her mother's death on January 1st, 1980, Little Ann took the reins of the famed Burnett Ranch's empire. Not since Bert Burnett ran the Sixes had a family member shown such interest in the ranch. Though she keeps her mother's home in Fort Worth and stays busy with several other interests, Ann returns to the ranch often and has a hand in every decision made there. She also loves a good horse and is full of sentimentality. There would be no other place in the world than the Four Sixes for champion racehorse Dash for Cash to spend his last years. I couldn't stand to think of him just spending the rest of his life in some barn where no one would care about him, she said at the time. In 1995, Ann donated a life-size bronze of Dash for Cash to the American Quarter Horse Heritage Center and Museum, which graces the entrance for all to see. Ann is also credited for success of the National Cutting Horse Association Futurity, a 2 to 3 week long extravaganza ending with a finals night that is standing room only. In the late 60s, Ann began selling box seats when the Futurity was only a 2 day competition with a scant fan following. Today, the waiting list for those box seats is as long as her arm. A lover of the outdoors, Ann is an avid marksman and enjoys hunting dove or quail on the famed Four Sixes. Her competitive and mischievous nature often carries over to her hunting, with wagers made on the day's take. Little wonder, Ann almost always had the upper hand at the end of the day. It is important to Ann Marion that the history of Texas and the West are remembered at the same time that new strides are taken forward. She was instrumental in locating the National Cowgirl Museum and Hall of Fame to Fort Worth, and in 1994 was honored with its Fern Sawyer Award. While preserving the past, Ann looked to the future by serving on the Board of Regents at Texas Tech University. She has endowed a professorship at Texas Christian University's Ranch Management School, and for years has been a major contributor to the AQHA Youth Scholarship Program. She and husband John Marion founded the Georgia O'Keeffe Museum in New Mexico in 1995. The museum is the first in the U.S. dedicated to an individual woman artist. Ann is also a trustee of the Kimball Art Foundation and is the director of the Fort Worth Stock Show, the Texas and Southwestern Cattle Raisers Association, the National Cowboy Hall of Fame, and the Fort Worth Zoological Association. She is a member of the Board of Overseers of the Memorial Sloan Kettering Cancer Center, an emeritus trustee of Texas Christian University, and a past trustee of the Modern Art Museum of New York City. One of her greatest passions has been the Modern Art Museum of Fort Worth, where she is a past president and chairman of the board. In 1996, through the Burnett Foundation, Ann purchased an 11-acre site in Fort Worth for the construction of a new building for the museum, designed by the world-renowned architect, Te Deo Ando. She continues to serve as chairman of the museum's building committee and co-chair of the Capital Campaign Council, and is a major benefactor of both the building and the collection. Recently, Ann has taken the lead in a redesign and beautification project for the intersection leading to Fort Worth's cultural district. For her civic and charitable works, Ann was honored with the Fort Worth Exchange Club Golden Deed Honoree in 1993, the Charles Goodnight Award in 1993, the Governor's Award for Excellence in the Arts in 1996, the Texas Business Hall of Fame recipient in 1996, and the American Quarter Horse Foundation Merle Wood Humanitarian Award in 1999. Ann shares her life with husband John Marion, honorary chairman of Sotheby's Incorporated, with her daughter, Wendy, and John's 4 children and 6 grandchildren. In addition to all this, Ann still oversees the operation of the largest individually owned ranch in Texas, 355,000 acres of land, and 8,000 head of Hereford and Angus cows in the North Central Plains. You'll often find her at the ranch for branding, where she's quite capable with a hot iron. In 1994, the Four Sixes Ranch received the AQHA Best Ramuda Award to honor the ranch's band of working cow horses that tends those thousands of cattle. 3 years later, the ranch received the inaugural AQHA Legacy Award, created to honor those who have bred American Quarter Horses 50 consecutive years. The ranch breeds about 100 broodmares each year for their own use. For decades, the Four Sixes has been involved in American Quarter Horse racing circles and now stands 8 racing stallions, including Special Effort, the breed's only Triple Crown winner. In an interview with the Fort Worth Star-Telegram in the early 90s, Ann said, "The most important thing that ever happened to me was growing up on that ranch. It kept my feet on the ground more than anything else. The tradition of the Four Sixes Ranch, the history of the West, a love for the arts, and strength for business. These things make up and win for Marion, the 2001 Golden Spur Award winner.